Ghent is one of the most beautiful cities in Europe. Located in Belgium, it is a beautiful blend of serenity and liveliness. Ghent is also known as a university city, considering it has many young people and students. The city center of Ghent is free of cars and other vehicles. It is an open area embracing people who choose to come here, and dissolving you in its sheer gorgeousness. Ghent also bears a historical significance. It was a rich and powerful city during the Middle Ages. Ghent is just half an hour away from Brussels by train, and is on the way from Brussels to Bruges. Most people use either Ghent or Bruges as a base to travel to either of these places: Brussels, Lille, and Antwerp. The city center of Ghent is quite small, easily walkable by foot. The main train station, Ghent St. Peter's, is not a part of the city center, so you may have to walk for about 30 minutes to reach the place. The best way out is to take a tram, which takes you to and fro the city center in 10 to 15 minutes. Apart from walking, people bicycle their way in and around Ghent. Most one-way roads often end up as two ways for bicycles. Step into the world of Harry Potter, a mystically unreal world with breathtaking sights. The place is replete with buildings with Baroque facings, cute cafes, restaurants, shops and massive cathedrals and the Gravenstein Castle. You can also enjoy a nice boat ride for an hour, for an estimated €7. You can expect to spend almost a full day here and enjoy it to the hilt. The belfry is synonymous with the pride of the city and has a historical significance. The construction of belfry started in 1313 and ended in 1380. Belfry is open from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. There are 255 stairs. They are easy to climb as they are not narrow. The view from the top of the belfry tower is definitely worth all the effort. You get fantastic panoramic views of the city from the top. St. Bavo's Cathedral. This is a stunning cathedral, located in the city center. You cannot take pictures inside the cathedral. Do not miss on the adoration of the mystic lamb. It is ethereal. Though the entry to the cathedral is free, there are a couple of euros per person to see the altarpiece, with a free audio guide. The cathedral is decorated with ornate design and fascinating marble work. You also buy souvenirs from the cathedral shop for a few euros. It is open from 8:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. Around 1 to 2 hours is enough to partake in the beauty of this place. Gravenstein Castle. This is a fairy tale moated castle, built by Count Philip of Alsace, Count of Flanders, after he came back from the Crusades in 1180. Walk through the turrets, moats, torture devices and the torture chamber. You can climb up the fortification of the castle and go up the rooftop, from where the view is simply breathtaking. You can expect to spend a couple of hours here. The timing is generally from 10 a.m. to 5:15 p.m., and the cost is about €10, as on 2018. 3 days is good enough to enjoy the beauty of Ghent. A rough itinerary should include spending your time at the city center, visiting the churches, taking a boat ride, photo opportunities in St. Michael's Bridge, climbing up the Belfry Tower and Gravenstein, taking a stroll in the beautiful cobbled street lane of Patichol, enjoying delicious Belgian waffles, frites and beer at Vrije de Gmacht, and going for a romantic, quiet stroll in the evenings. Have you been to Ghent? How was the trip? Do share your experience and tips in the comment section below.